Hello everyone, Abhijit from RGB Tutor. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create this Facebook Live reaction animation in Adobe After Effects with minimum effort. We will be using an inbuilt effects from After Effects called Foam to create this, so no use of any third-party plugin. Okay, before you begin with the tutorial, please take a moment to subscribe the channel. It will help me a lot. Okay, enough talking, let's jump into the video. Okay, so here I am inside the After Effects, and the first thing I need to do is create a composition. Rename it as main comp. Now just create a solid, so right click here, new and solid. Okay. Any color will work, so yeah. And now let's type in foam here. If you are not seeing this option, you have to go to window and enable this effect and preset option. So just search for the option foam and just drag it here. Now we have to go back to this project panel and let's import the emojis. Select the imported emojis and put them in composition panel and turn the I button off, and let's get back to the effects panel again. Now you see a red circle appear on screen. So let's select the foam option and position the circle to the right of the screen. We need to reduce this circle size, so let's keep it at 0. Now if we drag through few frames, you will see it is emitting some particles. So we need to control this particle emission through this production rate. I'm going to put something like 0.1 for now and see how many particles it is emitting. Okay, it's enough. Okay, now as you can see, these particles are emitting all over the screen, right? It's not following a streamline. So we need to follow a streamline for these particles. So how to do that? We need to go to this physics option, and first we need to put some speed for these particles emission. So I'm going to put something like 2 here. And the next thing I need to do is decide the direction of this speed. So I need this particle to go from the right of the screen to the left. So I'm going to put the initial direction at -90 degrees. The -90 degrees is the left. Okay, so I'm gonna put -90 degrees here. Now if you play, you'll see the particles are going from the right to the left, but it's still going all over this place. So we need to increase the wind speed a little bit. So I'm going to put here 2 as well, and for the wind direction, I'm going to select it as -90 like previously. Okay, so let's see again. It's pretty much on the line, but it's still few particles are moving up, which we need to control. So let's change the turbulence a little bit, maybe 0.6 or 7, and let's turn this wobble amount to 0. We don't need these particles to wobble, and the repulsion rate to 0. We don't need any repulsion rate, and the pop velocity to 0 as well. Now here is the thing, the viscosity. This viscosity will decide the weight of the particle, how light or how heavy these particles are. Okay, so right now it's at 0.1, so these particles are pretty light, and this is the reason it's going all over the place. We need to increase the viscosity amount to say, let's 1.5, to see how it's reacting. Okay, so it's in the line right now. If we play back a little bit, see, it's following the line right now. Okay, we don't need a straight line, we need a little bit of turbulence there. So this is it. I can increase a little bit more, like 2 maybe, and see how it's coming. Yeah, it's looking good. Okay, so now the next thing is I need to control the size of these particles. We need to control the size from this bubble option. Now here we have the size of the particle. So let's put something like 0.7 here. the size variance, I'm going to put 0.2 here. If you want all the circle to be of the exact same size, then you have to turn this option off to 0. And if you need a little bit of randomness in this size, you need to put something in the value. So I'm gonna keep it at 0.200, which works good. Now we have this lifespan option. This option controls how long this particle will stay on screen. For this tutorial, I'm gonna keep it at 300 only. So next we need to enable this rendering option, and first select this transparent and select solid on top. Now for the bubble texture, select user defined. For the bubble texture layer, here we have to select the emojis. So let's just click here and select one of my emojis. So we have four emojis here. I'm gonna select the first one and nothing changes. So you just go to this view draft and change it to rendered. Now you will see the emojis appearing. So we need to reduce the amount of the laughter emojis. To do that, go to this producer option and select something lower value. Let's select it as 0.01. Yeah, I think it's fine. Okay, so now what we need to do next is first rename this layer. Now I'm gonna duplicate this layer. We need to change the name and I'm gonna turn this lower one off for now and work on the heart emoji. So what we need to do now is just go to this rendering option again and I'm gonna select the second emoji, which is the heart. Okay, now the same way I will duplicate the layer two more times and replace the emojis. Once it is done, we need to change this random seed value for all the four layers. It doesn't matter what value you put as long as all the layers have four different values. So I'm gonna put here 8, and the next layer I'm gonna put something like 6, here I'll put 4, and in the first one I'll put 2. Okay, now I'm going to turn all this layer on and do a fray playback. It's looking pretty good, right? So if you are not satisfied with this, you can still make changes to this physics option. You can increase this viscosity even more if you want this to go a very straight line. So that's it for the animation. Now all you have to do is place a footage at the background. So just come back to the project panel and I'm gonna double click here. I'm gonna load this footage and I'm just going to place it at the end of the comp. In the final render, I added this rectangular outline and this live button to improve the overall look. You can do that with the rectangular tool in After Effects. So I hope this video was helpful and you learned something new. Let me know in the comment if you have any doubt, and please hit the like button, and if you're new to the channel, hit the red subscribe button. I'll be back very shortly with a new video. Until then, bye.